I think that donor behaviour in general is massively changing, and I think the charity sector has really struggled to keep up with that. I mean, the way that we pay has completely changed.
You know, the temptation with technology is to use it to utilise your existing donor base. And there might be times when that's definitely right, you know, better websites, different ways of having engaging conversations so that you're continuing to build engagement is really important. But some of this has to be about who is the audience for this, and is the technology giving you a new audience that you wouldn't otherwise have?
When charities are thinking about adopting new technology, you have to think very carefully about your own strategy. And we've seen that at TAP very clearly, because we're working with all sorts of different people who engage with our initiative to a different extent. Some people will install something in a cafe and we'll send them emails and the open rate is 10% and they don't tell their staff about it and it performs really badly. And we have other cafes that are really behind it, and they'll kind of incentivize their staff and they'll do competitions. And I think it's really important to remember that just because you've bought a new bit of kit or a new bit of tech, it's not necessarily going to bring you in loads of money. You have to keep working at it and you have to keep learning from the data that you're getting from it.
Emphasizing the trust message doesn't necessarily make people donate more. So the triggers for donating are still the connection to the cause. It's still the story, it's still the relationship with the charity, clearly. But I think that where the donations platform analysis comes in is trying to reduce that last minute resistance.
Fundraising is about relationships, and technology is not a replacement for that. And if we have to be very careful that technology is a facilitator and not a barrier to relationships.
We should be careful about how we use new technology. I think we should think carefully about the donor profile and who we're appealing to. And I also would really encourage kind of better collaboration between the sector. As a charity, and I say this as a supplier, you should be asking more of us. You should be asking us for more proof, more evidence on what works, what doesn't, what donor profiles they should be trying to hit. And I think if we do that, we can really get technology to kind of sing for us in the sector.
My key takeaway from the talk this evening was really getting a sense of the complexities of digital fundraising. There are some amazing new things coming out there.
Technology is becoming a part of every sector in some way. So it's interesting to hear about how the charity sector in particular are adapting to that.
There's a lot of talk around data, but to my knowledge, lots of charities don't really understand how to utilise it. They haven't got the training. And I think that's going to be really critical in getting that psychological shift into getting more people to donate.